very important through this channel about the muhaddith of Arabia, Saudi Arabia, Sheikh Sayyid Alawi Al Makki Al Maliki. Now, Hafiz Ehsan, sometime back, I remember discussing with you on the Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah Sufi scholars in Saudi Arabia. Now, this particular individual was living in Saudi Arabia and he has given ijazas to many students around the world, and he's a big scholar, he's a big mufti. My question is, number one, I would like to have a detailed discussion on Sheikh Alawi and to talk about certain incidents in his life story. First of all, are there any more Sufi scholars, Sunni scholars in Saudi Arabia, up to your knowledge, wherever you've been? I remember you've been to a lot of Maulud majlises. I remember you've been to a lot of Zikr majlises on Thursday nights, and it happens the way it is. Can you give us some thoughts on this? And later we will roll the ball on Sheikh Alawi al-Makki.
There are thousands of ulama in Makkatul Mukarrama, in Madinatul Munawwara, from Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah. And the real Arabs, they are from Ahlus Sunnah. Now, I'm mentioning this again, repeating again. The real Arabs, they are from Ahlus Sunnah. And they are such pious servants of Allah that they possess the true love for Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam in such a manner that many gatherings, I have been to some gathering where every Friday from Asr Salah until Isha Salah, within the gap of, after the gap is given for Maghrib as well as Isha, from Asr until Isha, the Maulud gathering is happening every Fridays on those Shuyukh's places. This is not only one place. There are plenty such places where the Maulud gatherings are happening. And Alhamdulillah, few I have visited as well. And with regards to the Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah scholars, there are many. They teach their students the proper aqidah of Ahlus Sunnah. But unfortunately, they can't teach in form of a madrasa because they are controlled by the Najdis there. So they do private classes. So in private, they educate their students, and there are many, many scholars of Ahlus Sunnah living in Makkatul Mukarramah, living in Madinatul Munawwara, and they come to the holy court of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They pay respect in such a manner, they say salam in such a manner that by seeing them, we are to learn adab from those people. Such Ashikur Rasul are living there. And also with regards to Sayyid Alawi Al-Maliki, Rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi. Alhamdulillah, when I was in Makkatul Mukarrama, it's about 20 years ago maybe, I could not meet Hazrat, but I went to meet Hazrat at his home, but unfortunately he was not at home at that time. So I missed the opportunity to see the blessed face of Sayyid Alawi al-Maliki, Rahmatullahi alayhi. But before I go there, I went there. In Makkatul Mukarrama, I inquired about him from a mutawwa, that there is a sheikh called Sayyid Alawi al-Maliki. Do you know him? So he got furious with me. He said, what Allah are you talking about? He is a kafir. He is a mushrik. And he is already dead. Whereas he was living at that time. He was physically alive on the earth. I know. And I went to meet him also. Unfortunately, he was not there. But that person, out of anger, he told me that he is a kafir. He has been buried in the grave like that. He was uttering in such a manner. And he did not tell me the place of the location of Sayyid Alawi al-Maliki. But later I got to know that, mashallah, at his home, he had many students who were learning the aqidah from him. And when I went to his home, though he was not there, I went inside and I saw the Salawat Sharif written beautifully. It was, the calligraphy was done very beautifully at his home. And especially, Inna Allah wa Malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. These things and the verses related to the excellence of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. By seeing that, I really enjoyed, and Alhamdulillah, I was happy that we got the opportunity to see the places where our pious servants of Allah, the pious servants of Allah are living. And Sayyid Alawi al-Maliki, as you said, he has many students, he has many khulafa. For your kind information, Ala Hazrat Imam Ahmad Raza Rahmatullahi Alayhi's son, the second son, Sayyiduna Mufti al-Azam Mustafa Raza Khan Rahmatullahi Alayhi, also gave khilafat to Sayyid Alawi al-Maliki Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayhi. So Alhamdulillah, we have connection with him in this way also, that he is the khalifa of our grand sheikh. And at the same time, he is a Sayyid Alawi al-Maliki, and he was following the Maliki Madhab. Now you see, apparently, he is publicizing that he is following Maliki Madhab. So that means there are followers of Hanafi, Shafi'i, Maliki, Hanbali, even today in the Arab, though that the dominated people, I mean, the people who have dominated is the Najdis, but it doesn't mean there are no Sunni scholars there. And Sayyid Alawi al-Maliki rahmatullahi alayhi was such prominent in teaching the Aqidah of Ahl Sunnah that very unfortunate, no, I won't say unfortunate, Sayyid Alawi Maliki, when he left this world, Sudaisi, the one who has been regarded as the best person to do Qirat and all, but we are to see his Aqidah, because we don't consider the Qirat without Aqidah, because our Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam foretold about this. You will find people who will recite Quran beautifully, but it won't go beyond their throats. So very clear. So this Sudaisi, he told that, I will not offer the Salatul Janaza of Sayyid Alawi al-Maliki because they were innovators, they were mushrik, etc., as explained by Dr. Dean Muhammad very clearly. And this is found in YouTube as well. But I would say that Allah has protected Sayyid Alawi Maliki for a Allah Wahhabi to conduct the janaza of a Sayyid.
Allah,
because
Allah,
why would Allah, a Najdi scholar conduct the janaza of a Sayyid, a great Shaykh? So I think that was the great thing happened. It could be said as the karamat of Sayyid Alawi Maliki, that the Najdi scholar were not, they did not perform the Salatul Janaza of a Sayyid. Alhamdulillah.
Allahu Akbar. It is interesting that you connected the dots of the students of Imamuna Ala Hadrat and Shaykh Alawi. I also would say that Shaykh Alawi al-Makki has kind of a Ba Alawi tradition also, which he brings. And this is where the famous statement, Hadrat, it is said in the internet where you can find that when Shaykh Alawi al-Makki used to live, and he finds students from the subcontinent come and meet him and discuss certain things, and if Shaykh Alawi is not sure about the Aqidah, Shaykh Alawi asks them, what have you got to say about Ala Hazrat? And when they hear the word of Ala Hazrat, if their face smiles and they are very happy, Shaykh Alawi knows who they are. And if their face gets very angry, Shaykh Alawi knows who they are. This is how it used to be.
And this was the sign during the time of Ala Hazrat as well. When any person from Indo-Pak subcontinent, when they go for Hajj or Umrah, and they meet the ulama of Ahlus Sunnah of Haramain Sharim, because at that time there was Sunni ulama under the Turkish ruling. So when they wanted to know whether this person is from Sunni or from the Wahhabi sect, they simply talk about Ala Hazrat in front of them, and they themselves say that we used to just see their faces. We just gaze towards their faces and see if they become happy by listening to the name of Ala Hazrat, we believe that he is a Sunni. And if faces changes, then we believe he is not from Ahlus Sunnah. So Ala Hazrat Imam Ahmad Raza Rahmatullahi Ali was regarded as a criteria for Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah, even among the scholars of Makkatul Mukarramah and Madinatul Munawwara.
Subhanallah, subhanallah. Going ahead with Shaykh Alawi al-Makki al-Maliki, like Sudais, you know, he was very harsh on Shaykh Alawi. Though Shaykh Alawi al-Makki had so many students, up to date, there are so many students who have directly studied with him and things like that. And also, he is the Shaykh of the Shadhili Tariqah, is a proof that the Tariqahs are alive in Saudi Arabia and things like that. Now, with regarding to all these traditions, Hafiz Ehsan, I would like to just say that up to your knowledge, you know, what is currently the statements which is happening in Saudi Arabia, where now Shaykh Alawi and his father used to teach in Makkah. And you would see when you go to Haram, sometimes these mutawwas, they keep a big chair and they start teaching to students. So what happened to Shaykh Alawi was stopped from here. His passport was cancelled. They want, because he used to travel to every part of the Middle East, he's traveled a lot, and they cancelled all that. The Saudi libraries had his books. All the books were taken and it was burned. So we lost a lot of traditions of Shaykh Alawi and things like that. So Hafiz Ehsan, why are the Sunni scholars facing this kind of challenges in today's world? And we lost big scholars like Shaykh Alawi. Shaykh Ramadan Al-Bhuti was killed by a Wahhabi terrorist. We have a lot of problems with protecting Sunni scholars and senior Sunni scholars. Is this a sign of one of the end of times, that the pious scholars are being taken up? What do you feel, Hafiz Ehsan? And Hafiz Ehsan, I want you to also check this particular video. Fazlur Rahman, can we add this video in a parallel screen? Where Shaykh Alawi al-Makki is teaching at Makkah. Now, why I wanted the viewers to listen to this video is just a portion of it is because I had some Wahhabis who said that Shaykh Alawi never taught inside the Haram Sharif. They said that. Shaykh Alawi never taught. But can you see this video where Shaykh Alawi is teaching inside Makkah?
وكان صوته في جنبات المسجد الحرام وفي مكة المكرمة يحيي الأرواح ويبهج النفوس ويطمئنها بأن منهاج الحق باق إلى قيام الساعة.
رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يتحنث في غار حراء ويتعبد معتذرا عن قومه وشركهم وفتنتهم وضلالهم حتى جاءه الحق. حتى جاء الحق وانكشف الحجاب وانفتح له الباب وبلغ بالرسالة فكان ذلك في اليوم السابع عشر من شهر رمضان وفي هذا اليوم المبارك أيضا وقعت أول غزوة حربية.
جزاكم الله خير فضل. Just to pause this video a little bit.
ما شاء الله.
Hazrat, they are talking about the important occasion of Badr, which we see today, even people don't talk about it. He is keeping a chair and wearing a green shawl, where when you see green color, the mutawas get a little bit agitated to see green. Ah, you're green, you're Sufi, who is it? He is the Mufti and he is wearing it in the middle of the masjid next to the Kaaba, and he is giving a talk on the Badr Sahaba without any fear. But this collar was later tied up, and this is the fitna. Is this a part of the end of times? What have you got to say, Hafiz?
Yes, in light of the hadith of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam, one of the signs of Qiyamah is that ulama will pass away swiftly. That means ulama will leave this world, and juhala, the jahils, the ignorance, will start giving fatwa. This is also one of the signs of Qiyamah. So we see this gradually happening, that many great ulama, they are leaving this world, and there are many more ulama who are working, and slowly, gradually, they also will leave this world. So a time would come that there will be ignorance spread. Today also we see that ignorance being spread, and it will spread furthermore. So being the sign of Qiyamah, what our Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam told is absolutely right. And further, when they have burnt the books of Sayyid Alawi al-Maliki rahmatullahi alayhi, and they have killed Sayyid Ramzan al-Buti rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi, from this is apparent, this is evident, that these scholars, they strived hard for the propagation of Aqidah of Ahlul Sunnah, and the followers of Wahhabism, they didn't want the real propagation to be propagated. For that reason, they are trying to destroy their books, and they preparing their own agendas in form of books. They are preparing their own Aqidah and publishing new books from Darussalam publication, which is affiliated with the Jews. Unfortunately, this is very, not unfortunately, fortunately, this is available online for us to see that who are behind the Darussalam publication, so that the people get to know the reality. Now tell me honestly, why would an enemy of Islam, about whom it is mentioned in the Quran that the Jews, they are the biggest enemies of the Muslims, why would that such enemy would support the scholars of Najd, the scholars of Saudi Arabia, or the scholars of Wahhabism, and why would they fund to propagate the books of these people? So this shows that there is a huge conspiracy. We always keep telling, our ulama always keep telling, it is up to the audience to comprehend it in a proper manner and be away from such people, from such books, from such any organization which are connected to the Wahhabism. Especially refrain from the books published by Darussalam publication. Even if they give a book on the excellence of Ghawthul Azam Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani, I would say never read. Because when these people can play in the translation of the Quran, when they can play in the translation of the Hadith, when they can tamper the tafsir and the books of Ahadith, it is not a big thing for them to tamper from the books of the great Awliya. So our audience should be very careful in this regard, and they should always ponder on the reality what our Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned about the signs of Qiyamah, and also that a time would come that it would be hard to follow the Sharia, to be firm on Islam. It will be easy to take a fire, coal of fire on your hand, but it will be hard to be firm on Sharia. So we are experiencing this little by little. Allah Ta'ala protect our Iman. And another thing, in light of the Hadith, a time would come that a person will be a believer in the morning, and evening he will turn a disbeliever. In the evening he will be a believer, next day morning he will turn a disbeliever. That means the ulama, when they leave this world, the proper guidance will be slow there, then people would be deviated. So we pray to Allah always for the protection of our Iman. And I would like to give this message to our audience. every prayer, after every prayer, pray for the protection of Iman. This is what we see from our pious predecessors. Whenever they are requested to do dua, first thing they ask is, Ya Allah, protect my Iman, protect our Iman. And then they ask for the wealth, for the health, and for other matters. But the first thing is Iman. I remember Sayyid Shah Turabul Haq Qadri Rahmatullahi Alayhi. You have met him, one of the great scholar of Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah. And Alhamdulillah, I had the opportunity to be with him for a long time, because when he used to come to Sri Lanka, he used to select our place and also my brother's place. We, the family, mashallah, my brothers and all, we enjoyed a lot. We learned a lot from Shah Turabul Haq Qadri Rahmatullahi Alayhi.
He was the one who conducted your nikah, I believe.
Alhamdulillah, he's the one who conducted my nikah, alhamdulillah. Even my brother's nikah, younger brother's nikah. So alhamdulillah, I saw in him, and he advised few things to us. He said that in his experience, he saw many people, many scholars deviating from the right path before their death. He saw many such people that before the death, people are deviating. So he said, now I understand the wisdom behind our pious predecessors, that they always used to say, my children, my student, my brothers, pray for my Iman. Pray for the strengthening of my Iman. Pray for the protection of my Iman. So he said that we realize now that why were our pious predecessors were so much worried about their Iman, and they were asking others also to make dua for the protection of Iman, because we see that people today getting deviated from the right path. So he was always concerned about that, and he advised us also that always pray for the safety of your Iman. Now, these are the important jewels and pearls what we learn from our pious predecessors. Now, just imagine, after they had left this world, there are very few people to guide us in this manner. So we should always ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala for us to guide on the straight path, on the path of the pious predecessors, to keep us under the shadow of a Kamil Shaykh, so that by their duas we are protected.
I think just to add on to that is that